Okay. So, yeah, Blender crashed. And let's yeah, the temp viewer is annoying. So now I have to go through and delete the temp viewer. Go back out. Go all the way out and reconnect this one to the output. Humanoid, period. There we go. All right. Yes, the hair across the body is because for whatever reason the vertex groups isn't being calculated correctly, or apparently at all, which the vertex groups are assigned inside geometry nodes, so it's just another geometry nodes bug. Which all this worked in 3.2, so yeah, everything broke in 3.5. Well, not everything, but enough. So that's what I'm trying to fix. I'm trying to do it the right way this time. Let's see, that's the left arm. Fingers, fingers, fingers. There we go. Keep your fingers crossed. So, got the inputs in there for arm length and torso width. So, I'm going to use see, the arm length. How am I going to do this? I need math. Arm length plus, no, add. There we go. Torso width. And it's going to be. So that should bring me to right there, and I'm going to subtract, let's just say subtract, I don't even know what numbers I'm using, so let's just try 5. So instead of indexes, I'm going to use positions. So the X is less than 0.5. So let's see what this looks like. Okay, so that deletes everything. So let's try 0.5. Oh, there's no, I need a less than. Haha. All right, let's back out so I get the model back. There we go. And I need a less than. I need this to be float. And this needs to be position. Then I'll break that off into separate X, Y, Z, and I believe the yellow, the red one is the X direction. So the X position. Now, let's see what that looks like. And I'm hitting period to make it do its thing. And it's deleting the entire thing. The position. position is less than the arm length. Alright, so let's put that back up there and change it to 1, change it to 0, change it to negative 1. And all of them shows up as nothing. Ah, I think I know what it is. Let's back out. There we go. All my points show back up. So I believe let's do an absolute value. Yeah, let's try that. And test it out. No. Why is it deleting everything? Oh, it's been forever. All right, let's just put that there, less than equal to 0. Okay, so less than equal to 1, 10, 15. Oh, I'm not converting the units. There is a units conversion that I do. I think it's like 32.5. Divide 32.5, and then subtract a number from it. Back out of this till I get my points back. So I know this is a troubleshooting process. The troubleshooting process takes a lot of time, especially if you haven't worked touched the program in 6 months like me. So I just got to find out what number system these uses. Use. And I'm backing out until this line goes. There we go. So there's a unit conversion. A scale. Well, it's basically scaling. Transform. Transform. There it is. So. That's the number I need. Go back over here to fingers. Then go inside the connection. And this should be multiply by a really tiny, super tiny number. Then put that there, and that's really annoying that it drops down because I have to cut it every single time. All right, so Let's do one. Five. Negative 10. All right, so we're getting somewhere. Negative 20. Zero. If it's less than, do I have those set up correctly? So what is this value here? 29.52. What is this value here? 23 and 5.9. So target mesh must have faces. Great. More bugs. So torso, leg length, torso length, torso width, 5.79. That's correct. Arm length should be 23.73. Arm length 23. Huh. That must include the fingers, the finger length. Okay, that doesn't. Where is he getting arm length from then? Oh, arm length is adding in. What is this? The arm length is the torso length multiplied by the torso width. Then, wow, I don't. So this makes the arm length proportionate to the chest. Like your torso length and width gives you a proportionality for your arms. Apparently this is the math for it. So that is correct, I believe. And where is temp connection? That's it. So these numbers are correct. So I need to know what number is this? 29. That's like 0.9. Let's multiply it by, let's copy that, but I'm going to multiply it by 1 for now. Negative 1. Negative 20. 20. 10. I could have sworn I did this before. I could have sworn that was exactly what I did earlier, and it deleted the entire arm. Okay. So. What? Okay. So, subtract 10. Which is actually should be proportionate amount of the arm. Let's see, subtract 5. And it's gone. Subtract 6. Okay, so apparently 6 is exactly where the arm lines up, and the length of the arm is 23.73. So let's try 23. 22, 23, 24, 25. Six. Yeah, see how that doesn't add anything more, because that this value includes the torso, which is not even included in this. So the torso, let me see what button is this to. Yeah, you can see, well, let's try an overhead view. Yeah, see how the arm, the beginning of the arm gives room for the torso. That's why going above, like, I'm subtracting out a maximum of the arm length, which is 23.73. Subtract out 23, and it gives you one notch. 23.5. Actually, I don't know how many. 24. 23.7. Well, either way, let's going to back out of this a bit till I get back to till I get rid of this line, since I know what I'm looking for now. I can't, I went too far. Okay. So, delete this. Let's see, get rid of this. Go all the way out to the upper layer. This is why I use Control Z to undo the view. Now, there might be another way of doing the view with the 3.5, I don't know what it is, haven't researched it. So, might be an easier way of doing it now. Alright, so fingers. Your correction. And get rid of this. And instead of subtracting, I'm going to multiply it by, I'm going to multiply. This number will be the arm length multiplied by some value. So this, I'm subtracting out anything where the X position is less than some number. So this, I'm trying to cut a hole for the thumb. And where did my thumb go? Okay, so the join geometry is moved. Alright, so the thumb is right there. Where'd the thumb go? As you can see, troubleshooting large groups like this is always so much fun. And this is another issue with using indexes. When you, the order in which you join the geometry matters. This is why you should never use indexes if you can possibly avoid it. Which eventually I'll get rid of all the indexes. So I'm trying to figure out why the thumb has disappeared. Because it's being joined right there. And oh, now let's see what it looks like. There we go. So what number does this need to be? 0.25, 0.3, 0.4. So where was it before? Greater than, less than. So that's where it was before, it's right at the edge of the thumb. Which is pretty much right there. 0.3. And now, for I need it to be the other part of this portion, needs to be greater than some position. So I can get rid of, actually I'm not going to get rid of these because I don't want the positions, because this looks really good position wise. So I need a greater than, greater than. And I'll reuse all these nodes. Actually, let's see, shift duplicate here, because it's going to be this same number. Control D, no, Control D, drag. I don't know. There's a way, there's some button combination where you can drag it, where you can make a copy, and it keeps all these connected, but I don't remember offhand what it is because it's been forever since I've used it. So let's try 0.4 just for giggles. This is 0.4, the length of the arm, subtracted from the length of the arm. See, there you go. It subtracts out a portion of the hand. Then I just have to scale it up. I'm not going to worry about undoing it because I'll just get rid of the temp viewer later. Because I need to be able to make modifications. Let's say 0.33. Actually, that might be exactly it. Way to find that out is to connect this down to here. Those seem to line up perfectly. Wow. That's some good guessing right there. And the other thing is I need the Z component. But to get the Z component, I need to add in more inputs. Because the height of the person is a variable, to find out where this is, I have to find the length of the leg and the length of the torso. Actually, where it spawns the arm, I should have a math formula that, let's see, where's the, let's go out. The left arm. All right, this tells me the position of the arm based on the leg length, torso length, and shoulder height. What is this? Shoulder height, torso length. Oh, I remember what it is. The shoulder height is represented as a percentage of the torso. So you can move the arm, you can move the arms up and down the torso. This will later be used to create multiple sets of arms. And everything will be seamless just automatically. Like you could produce, was it Goron from, the Goron, whoever it is from Mortal Kombat with the four arms. You can create that using this system and it automatically be seamless. And you can even turn the arms and the second pair of arms off and it'd still be just as seamless. Automatically regenerate the holes. So this is the math that I need. That's for the Z, which is the only thing I care about is the Z. So torso length, shoulder height, and leg length. I need to copy those inputs over into here. Arm height. Actually, this arm height might already be the number I'm looking for. It is. All right, so it's already got the input. So the arm height, I believe, should be the center point of the Z. So I need to transfer the arm height into this one. So I need an input here. Well, let me, what position? So it's the last one, so let's go arm height. Move it down to the bottom. Arm height, which is a math formula that I pull, that's the input of this is a math formula. So let's, wrong direction. Fingers, thumb connection, and then I add in shifty. Another boolean and position greater than. It's going to be some multiple of arm height. But let's just try the basic arm height first, just to make sure that's exactly what I'm looking for. Yes. See, the center of the arm is right there. So I want to have a multiplier. Shifty. A multiplier here. Try 1.1. That's too much. Oh. Yeah, it's going to... I want to think about this one. Because the arm height, any type of multiplier of the arm height is going to be dependent on how tall the person is. So, it would change the position of the cutout based on how tall the person is, which is not what I want. So I have to find, is there a variable for arm thickness? To find that out, I have to go back to where I made the arms, which is way out here. Fat multiplier, but I don't think that has any effect on the size of the hand. So, don't think there's a hand size variable in here at the moment. And the fat multiplier, doesn't have any effect on the height of the hand. So what else is there? There's some type of multiplier, I believe. That controls the thickness of the hand. Fat multiplier. What's this? Move out of the way. There we go. I don't think that has the hand in it. I think the hand is this part right here. Oh, nope, because that's muted. That's the hand. Alright, so what is the multiplier? The hand. So the arm starting point, that's just for the factor or the so it doesn't look there's any variables here. So I can just put in a constant in here. Put a constant in for now, because I think the hand size scaling is set to a constant. So I can go back into here, and instead of multiplying, I will add a constant, which 1.1 seems to be about the right number. I'm trying to get rid of everything that uses any type of point manipulation based on index, because every time the indexes change, it breaks the model. Okay, so it's definitely not quite that deep. So yeah, that's way deeper. Let's try 1.4. That's too shallow. Oh, that looks like the magic number right there. And yeah, sometimes I just throw numbers in there and see what works. It looks about the same. It doesn't need to be perfect. Probably needs to be a little bit deeper than that. Let's try 1.25. It needs to be about the same width, a little bit bigger than the thumb, because from the hand, it's going to go inwards towards the thumb on all sides, and the thumb is going to rotate up. So the next thing is, so this is the selection that it deletes out, and it's no longer using indexes. So I can delete this out. So now I can use how am I going to do this? Like, I want the selection to be uniform and very close to this. So I want there to be an and function there. Shift D. I don't know why I keep hitting Control D. You see how it rotates the endpoints, and let's do it along a different axis. So that's the Z axis. Let's try the Y axis. Yes, that's what I'm actually looking for, because I want to rotate the hole up about 90 degrees, but I don't want the ends rotated up 90 degrees. So that's where this comes into question. So I should just be that one. No? No, because it deleted all those points that existed. All right. So, how am I going to isolate out? So, that's. All right. Let's get the position and separate out XYZ. So, Shift D. Yes, there we go. Duplicate this. And where the X is not, no, where the X is, how, because I don't want the end or the beginning, so it has to be greater than the torso width. See, now those don't move any, but these still do. So I'll need to move this back, duplicate this, and we're going to use the X position again, less than. And this time it's going to be Control Shift D. There we go. That's the hotkey I was looking for. Control Shift D. So it keeps the value of these are connected to the arm length and the torso width, and it adds them together, which should be exactly this line here. So this value can feed into here. And this can feed into here. And doesn't quite get it. So we gotta subtract out another number from it. Subtract. Actually, it might be multiply. Let's try multiply. Multiply. By 0.9, 0.8. Getting there, getting closer. 0.75. Alright, where is the deleted point? Points. So this is a hot mess. Alright, so that subtracts out a third the length of the arm. So it actually should just be this value plus a very small number. So let's actually get rid of this and grab these three, Control Shift D, drag them down, and I'm going to make this a slightly smaller number, 0.29, and this should just work. It doesn't grab these points. It's only grabbing the points in the edges. Like, this should be a straight line up and down. I mean, this, it should rotate the entire hole exactly straight up and down, but it's not. It's not grabbing the points in the middle, which it's really important that it does. It's grabbing the ones on the edge. I know both of these are correct because that's what cancels out these. That's like right here. Because it's grabbing that one on the end and this one at the end, I know the greater than X and less than X positions are done correctly. That's how I know that. So for whatever reason, this part right here is not being calculated correctly. Edge versus face count is equal to 1. Alright, let's try a different neighbors. Shift add neighbors. Let's try vertex neighbors. Let's try vertex count less than 4. Exactly the same. Should be a straight line. Because all these are being rotated around the center. The mean, let's try the median. Pretty much the same. Vector selection should be 90 degrees. right, so let's see if I can scale. Scale elements with the same selection. Let's see. Edges. Uniform. 0.5. Whoa. Where did you go? Why'd you do that for? Single axis on the Z axis. Why is it grabbing the whole thing? I didn't change my selection. Sometimes it gives really, really, really weird behavior. Center should be here. Like, this selection and this selection are exactly the same, but they yield different results. I see that it just doesn't quite work the way it's supposed to yet. Like, this selection comes from the exact same set of principles. Like, none of these faces... Oh, these are edges. Edges will yield a different, because this is vertex neighbors trying to go into an edge selection. It will yield different results. But edge neighbors... works. See? It works. But it doesn't... it doesn't rotate, it doesn't select these middle lines. And they only have, like, this edge right here only has one face. Yeah, see, this edge right here only has one face. Oh, but set position is working on... it's working based on points. And this is using edge neighbors. Okay. That's why... all right. So when you're setting position of points, you need to use a point thing. When you're setting the position of edges, you need to use edge neighbors. So how am I going to do this? First, let's undo what I just did. Alright, so let's plug this back in. Mute that. So now I get roughly a straight line. Now I basically want all this over again and combine it with this. So I'm going to Control Shift D, move these down, cut this line here, and use edge neighbors to control the edge selection for scaling. There you go. So hopefully, watching this really long video troubleshooting, you learned something very specific to set position, scale elements on edges, and edge vertices and vertex neighbors. And I also want to move the whole thing closer to the thumb. Let me think about that. I want to move the center of this to the center of this. So I'll mess around with this offset. So this was position. So I want the center of this. So separate XYZ on the X position. How do I want to do this? I want to move the X to where the thumb is. So how do I determine where the thumb is? Well, thumb is pretty close to uniform, and I don't need the centers exactly the same. So I'll take attribute statistic and position. Nope, shift click. All right, and control shift duplicate. Except I'm not going to use the selection or. Going to use this one and get the center of the thumb and control duplicate. Nope, shifty. There we go. Get the mean of it, and I'm going to I'm going to subtract one from the other. I don't know which is which, so I'm just going to try one. Combine X. Add that into here. And I'll either move it that way. And then I just swap these two. Oh, it moves it to the center of the X. No. I want it to move to the minimum. There we go. Why? Oh, it's because I need to adjust. Cause the selection here is only grabbing. Yeah. Because of the position here. So, let's try a larger 0.28. 0.27, 0.2, 0.25. It's not grabbing The one's in the z coordinate. What's the terminating? That's by the x, that's by the x. The z shouldn't matter. Why is it not? It's not seeing these. I don't know why. See the, oops. So the top's moving and the bottom should be coming up, and they should be meeting basically in the middle. So it's just purely the selection. See, that selection is correct. That selection is not. So the edge neighbors. Got to be that one, which I tested this one. .22, and it grabs everything. .23, .24, .25. It grabs just the thumb hole, but doesn't grab the lower ones. And this is basically the vast majority of working with geometry nodes, is trying to figure out why the selection isn't selecting what I want it to select, when I want it to select. Let's actually duplicate this. Shift 2. And also add into the Z. Right now, I want this one to be mean. No. Then control shift duplicate. This one will be the mean, and the Z will go into here. And the Z will go into here. Moves it up. And why is it not? Why are these moving down? Because the center's not in the right place. So why is the center? Aha! So if I don't pick a center, it automatically picks its... That's what it was. So the selection was correct, it was just not picking the correct center. Alright, so this is actually what I was trying to get. Not quite, because it sticks out. It shouldn't stick out like that. like it should. I think what the problem is nope, that's not what I'm looking for. I need to be able to see where the points are without seeing the points in the back, and I don't know the command to do that. Like, it should form... Oh, it wouldn't form a straight line. I know why it's doing that. Let's scale it in the X. We want to scale the exact same thing in the X direction. There you go. Now I have a straight line. Because when it's not rotated, it's not a straight line. It makes a curve that when you're looking at it from this angle, you can't really tell. So it is rotating everything, including the curve, so that the top part would stick out, which is not what I was looking for. I needed it to be a straight line like that. So what I have now is two holes in a single plane where all the points on the thumb, all the points on the thumb are on the same plane and are relatively close to all the points on here. So that's exactly what I was looking to do to fix it. I know this looks complicated, but this is still a lot easier than the miles and miles and miles of code using point indexes. So next step is to use proximity to move them again. I actually have to do this twice. First, I'll move... how do I want to do this? How do I describe this? Because the number of points on the opening is different here than it is here. So, I'll want to move the points on the hand to the nearest point on the thumb. So, I'll do a set position, Shift D, and the hand so I want how do I describe this? Because I need the selection. And again, I will need vertex neighbors, Shift D, less than 4. Which I'll demonstrate that. Point 2. See how it grabs all the edges there? And here. But I don't want the ends, just the middle part. So I'll have to add in another AND statement. Actually, I'll have to use two of them. No, wrong boolean. Boolean math. Boolean math. Duplicate it. So it needs to be this and I think I can Actually, I should still be able to use this right here. Because everything still matches. So let's try. Let's just try it. Yeah. This right here. 0.1. Perfect. 0.2. Alright. So I don't need any of this. I'll just use the selection from earlier. Yes, spaghetti mess. Spaghetti! Alright, so I need to move that. So the position I need it to move to. So I need a proximity node. Proximity node. Oops. Shift A, proximity. And I won't add it in there. I'll actually make a little knot there. Add it into there. Source position is position. Because this will read in the position of this. That should just work. No? No. 0.1? Nope. Actually, no. Ha ha ha. It's taking the position of itself and seeing how close it is to itself. Okay, so. Now. Shift. I need to go to the thumb. See how it makes. Alright, let's mute this node so you can see what it's doing. See, it's maybe I'll see it better here. See, yeah, it's shrinking and going to the correct position. Let's see if I can get inside the thumb so you can see it better. See, let's mute this again. I actually don't want it to scale that small, so let's try 0.6. Mute. Alright, so there is some gaps and some issues, but this is fixed. So I'll duplicate this one, these three. So Shift D. And here I'm actually going to cut out this and go here. And you want to make sure it's coming out after you get this one. And this, the output from this, goes into here. That actually shouldn't be faces, it should be points. That was probably one of the problems. Selection needs to change to, what is it? Vertex neighbors, face count less than 4, ta-da, the end cap. So the end cap isn't sealed, which is why I'm having problems with it. these points aren't merged together yet. So where because the merge node actually eats up some processing time. See, merge by distance. Yeah, see the thumb cap right there. Merge by distance. And now I can unmute this. And there's no. I don't want faces, I want points. Well, that should work, and it just doesn't. I've used this exact same setup in other places and it works fine. Oh, just lots of troubleshooting. Anyway, how long is this video? It's been an hour, so I'm going to go and cut it off.